exactly the same. And after that, we will vote. We'll tell you the winners of both one first round and second round, okay? So stick around for at least two rounds, and you'll know who's going to the finals. At the finals, four artists will participate. And then we'll clown the new artist. Okay, guys, are you ready to meet your artists? Okay, just remember, have a fun time, vote, enjoy the art, take lots of pictures, okay? Our first artist, it's so great, it's his birthday today, which is pretty amazing. Love you, Michael. He says his art is like an eighth grade math teacher on acid trying to throw out their dreams. I love that. Please welcome Michael Walker. Come on out. There he is. Birthday boy. This artist is a San Francisco designer with hair like Lucille Ball. You'll find her roaming the city looking for inspiration. Euleterio, come on out. Euleterio Lopez. You are looking sexy tonight, baby. Owning it. If we were just voting on that outfit, I think you'd win right away. This gentleman is a legend. He's been here many a times. He's won many a times. He's coming back. He grew up drawing and graduated to a paintbrush. His art is often a mashup of multiple techniques utilizing his vivid imagination. Let's give it up for Tommy Percasso. Yes, come on out, Tommy boy. Yes. Is that a cold one you have in your hand? Always, baby. I know how you do. I'll be thinking about you in the shower. Okay, here we go. This next artist has been painting since she was 4 years old. She paints works inspired by aesthetics of water and its nature. Let's give it up for Baya Roche. Baya Roche. And the outfit is stunning. She's walking the catwalk already. Nice ink on her. This guy is just a classic artist. He focuses on drawing, painting, digital, and AR art. Neil Franks. Give him some love. Coming out, Neil Frankenstein. Yes, baby, working out. Finally, our sixth artist for round one is a local San Francisco artist and shopkeeper of Just for Fun in Noe Valley. That's a great store, by the way, if you haven't been there. Really cool store. She got inspired to pick up a paintbrush by her neighborhood artists, Elizabeth Decker and Clint Frederick Whitehorn. Please give it up for Michelle O'Connor. Yes, Michelle! All right, let's give a big round of applause for Mike Lee in the booth. He does all the lighting. He's going to do all the countdowns. He handles his business. Yes, he's probably been up for 24 hours, but he's still working with us. Here we go, guys. We put it up on the board, so we're going to start it right now. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, art battle, round one. All right, guys, now it's your job. Let's go counterclockwise today. Counterclockwise. Can we make it happen? Keep walking. Count. Yeah, that's right. To your right. To your right. Have another drink. Enjoy. Smoke another joint. To your right. All right, there you go.
All right, welcome everyone. We are here for Art Battle San Francisco tonight, and we have just begun round number one with our first six artists. My name is Morgan Booth, and I am here with Art Battle co-founder Chris Pemberton. Hi, Chris.
Hey, Morgan. How are you tonight?
I am so good. We just had an amazing event last night for Art Battle Toronto, so I'm really riding an Art Battle high right now, and I can't wait to see what these San Francisco artists bring to the easel.
Oh yeah, it's always really great in San Francisco, and we've got some new artists in here tonight. It's pretty exciting at the Great Northern, where Art Battle San Francisco is held. It's always great energy, and there's a good crowd there tonight.
Oh, for sure. The energy in the room is palpable, and we have some artists up at the easels who have definitely got their battle stripes already. We are looking at Tommy Percasso, who actually, I was counting his events today, he has painted in 15 art battle events.
That's incredible.
He is definitely super into the live painting scene.
Yeah, he's painted in San Francisco and Oakland, at least those two places, a number of times.
And here we are with Baya or Rita, and this is Baya's second art battle. And we often see from Baya very seascape-oriented pieces that have a lot of emotive quality as well.
Looks kind of like she's working on that right now, actually. That looks like it's going to be a seascape. Working with the knife, the palette knife there.
Yeah, getting some of that signature Baya texture in there.
Absolutely. Art Battle San Francisco, since the city finals, which were held late last month. So we're back at it with a new season. This is the first event of the new season. Tonight, of course, we haven't had the national championship for 22-23 yet. That's coming up later next week, but we are starting the new season here tonight in San Francisco.
And these artists are eager to see who will move forward and claim the very first spot in the 2024 San Francisco City Final.
Yeah, there's a lots of events in San Francisco. It runs every month, so we get a lot of champions in the final events there, and the quality just shines through for sure.
And here we are with Neil Franks, and Neil looks like he's going in with some paint markers and starting off with some strong drawing techniques with a very thick marker at this point.
Is this Neil's first art battle?
This is Neil's first art battle, Neil's art battle debut.
Oh, very exciting time then. I wonder how he'll be able to handle the 20-minute time limit. Nice big clock up on the projection screen here. This venue has it all. Good lighting, good audience, audience is close to the painters. Painters are on an elevated stage, got the time clock on the projection screen and a great DJ. So everything is pumping tonight. It's going to be a very exciting edition of our battle.
Absolutely. And here we are with Michelle O'Connor as well. And we can see that Michelle is starting off with some drawing techniques, although we are almost 5 minutes total into the round. So I'm hoping that Michelle starts moving into some of that painting as we get more into our time limit.
Yeah, kind of hard to see with the shadow there what she's working on, but a lot of painters start this way, drawing in their shapes and figures and then filling it in later, and that's what we're going to see here. I think maybe she has broken out a marker to start fleshing out her sketch a little bit more.
Yes, starting to see some of those features emerging.
There is somebody's cool paint kit. Who are we watching now, Morgan?
I believe that we are with Michael Walker, and I think that this is actually Michael's third event painting in Art Battle. And he describes his work as being Cubist Futurism, which I think is a pretty cool title to name a style.
Cubist Futurism. That's very interesting. I see he's working on what looks like a interesting a face going on there, but it's going to be cubist and futuristic.
And here we are moving on to Eleuterio Lopez, and they are just doing such an amazing job. We're getting all of these beautiful lines. This piece is almost reading like it's been carved from a lino block with all of these carefully hatched lines in here.
Yeah, absolutely. And I mean, they've got so much work done in just a few minutes here. It's like it was already there and they're just brushing it off.
Very impressive. And I believe that this is actually Eleuterio's first time painting in AB as well. And we can see that they are definitely managing their time very well.
That's great. The first time is always a challenge. The 20 minutes goes by so fast and you have ideas about what you want to do. But unless you have practiced a lot in the studio, it can be very overwhelming to get your painting done in 20 minutes, especially the first time.
And we are at the 12 and a half minute mark officially now. And voting is now open for round number one. Although you may not want to vote until you see how these pieces completely turn out, you can get registered to vote at artbattle.com/AB2460 and make sure that you're ready to jump right in there and pick your favorite painting.
Absolutely. Every vote counts. We have a lot of really close votes, and often we're waiting for the last votes to come in before we're able to make a decision. So as soon as this round is over, have a look at all the paintings and cast your vote. You can only vote for one, but two artists from this round will go through to the third and final round. Oh, lost the camera there for just a second, but now we are right back in here. Really good view of two paintings being created simultaneously and side by side. Some similarities between the two of them and a lot of differences.
Yeah, we have kind of more of a minimalist angularity from Michael, and then we still have that same kind of leaning into cubism and careful angles within Eleuterio's piece, but Eleuterio is definitely going more complicated, and then Michael is more minimalist in making those shapes.
Yeah, interesting, because, you know, the simple piece will speak to some of the audience, and the more complicated piece will speak to other members of the audience. That's the beautiful thing about Art Battle, is there's really something for everyone, as in every round we have six completely different painters and paintings happening. And we are now just approaching the 10 minute mark. That means we are half of the way through the first round, with half of the first round to come. So the 10 minute mark has just passed. These artists are well on their way. We can see, for most of them, we can see what direction they're going in and how their painting is going to shake out. But for a couple of them, we're still waiting to see what's going to happen. But that's the amazing thing, and why you do want to hold your vote to the end, because these paintings can change right down to the last second.
And I'm just loving the way that Eleuterio's specifically is evolving. I feel like they're starting to make all of these gestural marks at this point and really bringing in some more organic energy over top of some of the angular lines.
Yeah, and now we are back with Tommy. You know, as we mentioned, we've seen Tommy many times, and all of his paintings are very different. You know, he has some abstracted faces that he likes to do, but this one is completely different. I haven't seen a piece like this from Tommy before.
And the color play between Michael's chosen colors, this wonderful ultramarine blue here, right up against that red, is just a really satisfying moment. I like that Michael has chosen the more saturated versions of these colors and then has toned out colors in the same color family right next to them.
Yeah, some very mature use of different colors and what's available on hand. Of course, you know, everybody starts with the same number of colors to choose from, but of course their artistic choices take it in all different directions. And that's why, you know, after many years of running these shows, every night we still see brand new paintings, and it's going to be like that for a very long time. This is sort of an underwater scape here. Doesn't really look like, it could be, it's sort of hard to tell. It could be a view of a rough sea. Could be the bottom of the ocean. Very hard to tell.
I have actually seen Baya before change these pieces right at the last minute and almost add this kind of outer space vibe to it. So I'm wondering whether or not she's going to do that within this sky, because we have that kind of dark area.
Mm-hmm. Could be.
And Neil's piece is just so much fun. We have our toast and toaster here.
Yeah.
Getting in there with some really sharp line work. And it's funny, we just saw Neil kind of pull away from the canvas for a second, and you can see his smile. He knows how clever this piece is and that he's bringing some humor to the audience as well.
Yeah, humor is a very interesting choice. We you know, we see that every once in a while, usually maybe one per tournament, maybe one every other tournament, a real humorous piece. And you often wonder what the artist is, how do they come to the decision to take their time on the stage to sort of, you know, share a humorous joke, maybe not have the best chance of winning. But, you know, that's what it's like. Being an artist is your own choices, and what you want to put forth into the world definitely comes first. So we see all sorts of different displays, and this toast and toaster humorous piece is definitely really cool.
And back over with Michael and Eleuterio here. And just continuing to watch these pieces evolve.
Yeah, this is a nice spot. Very cool to see them both working. Eleuterio's piece, they've got so much going on. They've been able to add so many little details, different color patches, different styles, different brush strokes. It's a really cool piece, yet it's still very strong. So that's going to be a contender.
This piece for Michelle is just coming together so wonderfully. I love the vibrancy of the pink here.
Yeah, it's very cool piece. She's now working on this, sort of has it down flat to work on. A lot of painters do that. You kind of have a little bit more control when you've got the piece on the ground. But with Art Battle, you do have to put your piece up on the easel at the end of the round.
The curveball there. I feel like a lot of artists forget about that rule because they can spend the entire time working on the ground and then the piece is subject to gravity once it's lifted onto the easel to be viewed by everyone.
Absolutely. That's something that you have to take into account when you're doing your painting, that it is going to slide a little bit. You know, we do see artists leave them on the ground at the end of the round. Now we're trying to make this the best viewing situation possible for our audience. That's why we like to get them up there on the easels. And I'm sure that hers is going to get up on the easel at the end.
And checking out Michael's paint box here with all of his bevy of tools.
Yeah, I can see the future, the cubist futurism going on there.
Yeah, I feel like we have some of those classic markers of cubism, and then it's brought more into this contemporary realm with the color choices. Definitely much more vibrant. Mm-hmm. And Eleuterio's piece here is just vibrating with so much energy. The way that they have layered all of these lines, the colors really are merging and blending, and there's areas where we have higher saturation and that color is punching through, but then it's right up against the black and it's starting to fade back in other areas. It's a fun kind of competition with these colors within this piece.
Yeah, it's very cool. I mean, there's been so much work done on this canvas, but it's not muddy at all. It's quite clean and really shows, you know, a lot of detail, a lot of individual brush strokes, all differing from each other, but coming together to make this quite a clean piece, actually.
Moving over soon to check out what Tommy Percasso is up to.
Oh yeah, we got a little cartoon going on here. This looks like a Betty Boop of sorts. And maybe she's in a evening gown holding a curtain.
Yeah, a curtain. I was wondering what the red components were. I was wondering if there was maybe some abstract element within the background, but it's definitely a curtain and she's kind of cheekily pulling it to the side.
Yeah.
So we are now 4.5 minutes remaining on the clock and voting is now open. So make sure that you get registered at artbattle.com/AB2460. The top two artists from this round and the top two artists from our next qualifying round, round number two, will be moving forward to a four artist final showdown and you will get to see those top artists paint again. So choose well and choose who you want to see step up to the easel once again.
Yeah, you know, it's very important. Everybody takes their role as a voter very seriously. And does vote for the piece that they think is the best. And, you know, we just see that, you know, event after event that the audience really does know what they're doing and does choose the painters who are having the best night to go through to the finals. So, you know, we know that this is a different way of viewing and experiencing art. We know that it works and we know that these painters are all really excited to be performing in front of an audience. So it's win-win-win, and this is just going to be another really fantastic night. I can't wait to see these finished pieces all side by side in the voting app, and I will go from there to see who we vote for. As of right now, I can't say who I would vote for. I don't know.
Yeah, there's a few standouts. I think that Baia is a standout for me right now just because I love really textural painting. And I'm also very excited to see what Michelle O'Connor has going down with that very vibrant pink portrait that she was working on.
Just over 2 minutes left now, and we have some... the sides are getting painted up here on this cheeky toast, bread and toaster piece. And you can see actually that the time on our screen is not matching up with the time on the wall in the venue. So we will have to watch as we get down there to see how much time is actually left, but it's not much either way.
Yes, time is definitely ticking down for our final moments for these guys. And getting, once again, with that careful line work from Neil. I love the mustache. That's the best part for me.
Yeah, it's a very cool mustache. I love the little hat, to be honest. Everybody needs a little hat.
And the fact that it's just on one side of the curve of the bread, it just makes it that much cheekier.
Yeah. He's enjoying his work. He's sharing a little laugh with the audience member. And he's wondering if he should do anything else or if he should just cap it and wait for the end of the round. And I think that is what he's going to do. We see Baia there working on what is now clearly an angry sea. A very cool piece, lots of texture. Hopefully we're going to move around now and take a look at the next piece.
Back with Michelle O'Connor and this very stylized illustrated portrait. I'm really digging it. I like that the eyes are very stark in contrast to the rest of the piece.
Yeah, interesting choice just to work in the center of the canvas and to leave the outside sort of untouched, you know, that can play in many different ways with the audience. You know, some people like to see the whole canvas used. Some people like the minimalism. I think that it has its place, and if done well, it's a great way to frame a piece. We have yet to get a good straight-on view of this one, but we will be able to better judge the success of it in just a couple moments as we move through here.
I feel like we're getting some really great expression of attitude from that character. And we are now into our final 2 minutes. I just heard our MC in the venue.
Oh, this piece has changed quite a bit.
Yeah, we've now taken on a lot more kind of pattern and detail work within the larger kind of puzzle piece components. Very cool.
Yeah, it's kind of got a little bit of a cyborg thing going on there.
We are now into our final minute. We have 1 minute remaining.
Yeah, we're probably not going to see too much change here in the last minute, but it is very crucial and very tough often to decide if your piece meets your expectations. Sometimes painters try and flip the script in the last 30 seconds by totally changing something. Not sure how that goes, but I think here most of these pieces are pretty much done, just having the final touches put in. Back here with Tommy working on his stage curtain pulling Betty Boop.
The fact that she's nude almost is giving her more of a feeling of innocence. She's feeling very vulnerable.
Yeah. Looks like that Baya is finished her piece. Very cool. Would really love to see this one in person.
Oh, Rose is dead. Okay. Artists, please bring everything back. It's your turn now. Bidding is open and voting is open. So vote for your favorite artist and bid on your favorite painting. Big round of applause for round one artists. Thank you so much. You guys kicked ass. All right, start voting. Start bidding. We'll be back with round two in about 15 minutes.
And what a fantastic round, our first round for Art Battle in San Francisco. And so many different styles displayed on the easels by our amazing live competitive painters in round number one. You can vote for your favorite artist at artbattle.com/AB2460. And when you're thinking of which piece you want to vote for, not only should you be thinking of which piece resonated the most with you in terms of its visual, but also which artist's performance did you enjoy the most, because the top two artists from this round and the top two artists from our next round will be moving forward to a third and final round, and you will get to see them paint again. So we will be back in just a few minutes for our second round and our next six artists stepping up to the easels. Stay tuned.
Thank you.
born in Pueblo, Mexico. The first discovered kindergarten. She loved art. She loves painting 3D sculptures of her cat and her turtle. How amazing is that? Let's give it up for Elsa. Or a turtle tonight. No? Not getting cats or turtles. Wonderful. Anyways, next artist. He tends to script detailed balance from choice. He makes things sort of warped. I love that description. Sort of warped. Let's give it up for Blake Hammond coming out right now. He is the only gentleman in this round. He means business, too. Our fourth artist is colorful, yet dark. Her work is free and constantly changing. She's inspired by nature's colors, textures, and mind tricks. She's coming out right now. Give it up for Amber Brady. Get it, Amber. I think Amber has some fans in the house tonight. The majority of this next artist's work is colorful renditions of sex worker photos on social media. Give it a round of applause for that right there in itself. With their consent, she depicts them to promote sexuality acceptance, body positive, but most importantly, awareness and safety standards for all sex workers. Hell yeah! Give it up for Cece, representing them. Cece's always holding it down. Cece, it's great to have you back in the house. That's my girl right there. Okay, our last artist is known for her artwork about the human condition, still a bit more comic than tragic. I've known her for 47 years. Let's give it up for my mama, Katie Farrell. Come on out. Hi, Jules. Love you, Mom. No sympathy vote for the mom, though. If you like her work, you vote for it, okay? That's what I'm telling you. No more free rides, Mom. Here we go. All right, guys, we're going to do this round two right about now. Can we get a little 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, battle round two, here we go.
All right, we have just begun round number two of Art Battle in San Francisco. And right now we are checking out this artist who is working on the floor and is spraying paint down onto their canvas. This is a really interesting start, and I absolutely cannot wait to see how this piece evolves from this very brave and textural start. And oh my gosh, I love this artist's outfit as well. Definitely, she came to battle. This is Natalie Lenderman, and Natalie loves to ride the line between abstraction and landscape work. So I've been especially excited to see Natalie paint today because I wanted to see what exactly that means. And we can see that Natalie is just layering on all of this paint. We have quite a few tools that are already making an appearance at the easel. We saw Natalie throwing some paint down on the canvas when it was on the floor. Now she's using a spray bottle. We saw her use a scraper at one point already. And this is, I think, three or four techniques at least that we have seen in just our first two rounds. And Natalie has now brought a fourth or fifth technique out with a sponge that she has dipped directly into the paint and is applying. Here we are with Ilsa, and this is Ilsa's second art battle ever, and we can see that she is going super fast here and getting quite a lot down on the canvas. We have lots of blue paint, and we're starting to get these kind of wave shapes appearing. And something that's really interesting about Ilsa is that she also creates sculptural work within her painting. So she does these miniatures that are all having painted components, and also introduces sculptural elements within her her painting work as well on canvas. So I'm really looking forward to seeing how she brings that to the easel here.
Hello, Morgan.
German name.
Hi, Chris.
How are you?
So good. We are 4 minutes into our second round for Art Battle in San Francisco.
All right. Looking good. First round was really cool. And now six new artists.
Yes, six new artists up at the easels. Right now, we are checking out Blake, and they are going in with some really expressive brush marks and kind of a central character focus.
Looks like a sort of a beast character.
Yeah, we've got these big arms kind of looming over the rest of the composition. Still very abstracted at this point, though.
Yeah, still a lot of detail to come here. And they're working around the outside with those sort of earthy tones. And yeah. I think we're going to see more clarification on the figure in the middle, too.
I'm really interested in those daubs of pink that are in the middle of our kind of looming character there. Within all of that kind of black inkiness, that little hit of pink is a bit of a surprise.
Yeah.
Over with Amber Brady now, and Amber actually painted with us in Monterey in 2019.
Oh, very cool.
And it looks like we are getting treated to what I believe is going to be a seascape. I'm so into this hit of that fluorescent green.
It's really nicely done there, for sure. That can be a tricky color.
Yeah, that's definitely a challenging color because it can compete, it can get muddy. It's really a wild card of a color, and you have to have such great blending control when you're using it.
Yeah, it takes a subtle touch, for sure. There's a few colors that are like that, and it takes experience at Art Battle to know which ones to use and how often.
And we can just see Amber's brush dabbing across the sky here, starting to build in some soft, fluffy clouds.
Really like the ocean part of that one.
Me too. And here we are with Cece. And Cece, I believe, is working on a bodyscape here. We have yellow being the dominant color, and I think that we are looking at the back of our figure.
I think so. I think this is an explicit look at a figure.
Yes, definitely. We're getting lots of rounded lines within the body here as well. I think that the figure's probably bending forward.
Did she use spray paint? It almost looks like it.
I'm not sure. I don't think that we caught that yet. But I wouldn't be surprised. And this is CC's second art battle.
All right. CC.
And bye. I love seeing her rock out right now.
Yeah.
That's one of my favorite things. Doing art battle commentary is seeing how joyful the artists are up at the easels.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun. I love to see the dancing at the easels. It's all the things for sure.
And here we are with Katie, and Katie has quite a lot done. Definitely has the background fully blocked in there with this super vibrant yellow.
Yeah, that canvas looks like it came that way.
Yeah, so opaque and so even, which can be actually quite difficult to do with yellow.
Yeah, so even. It's a really good job, and on the sides too. So.
And we have two figures hanging out in our environment here, throwing their hands up in celebration. It's feeling like Adam and Eve a little bit.
It is.
In our garden of earthly delights.
Yeah, very interesting piece. And still half the time left. We'll see what happens.
And heading over to Natalie Lenderman. Oh, this is cool. So within the first 2 minutes, we saw Natalie do almost four different techniques. We saw her squeeze paint right out of the tube onto the canvas when it was on the ground. Then we saw her lift it up and use this scraper and then a sponge and then a spray bottle. So I was really wondering where this piece was going to go in terms of texture, whether or not it would be more wet or if we'd have a thicker application.
Mm-hmm. Is there tape in there?
I didn't see any application of tape, but you know, given with Natalie's penchant for switching up her styles or techniques, I would not be surprised if there's tape in there somewhere.
Yeah, that would be cool. I think that she's in the full improvisational flight here.
Ooh, I'm really enjoying those drips. I love seeing an artist apply right out of the tube. I don't know why, but there's something that's really satisfying and a little wild about it for me.
Yeah. Yeah, that's good times. That's luxury to paint out of the container.
Totally. 100%. And it looks like Natalie's using, I think, an ink potentially here, or some sort of super thin down, maybe a fluid acrylic.
Very cool to get to watch her paint, for sure. This is great.
And over now with Ilsa. And this beautiful rolling landscape.
Yeah.
It's definitely taking on surrealist vibes as well with this kind of hanging orb from the sky.
Do you think she practiced this piece?
I do think she did. I think that there's some pretty careful spatial management here in terms of where the placement of the blue is, and then we've got these mountains right at the horizon line. I feel like she would have had to plan all of these components and where she was going to place them. This doesn't feel like a totally improv piece to me.
No, she planned it out. This is the piece that she's going to do. That floating eye in the sky.
Yeah, that's our one kind of super surreal component that just makes you look at the rest of the painting in a different way, because with that element of strangeness, it allows you to kind of look at the rest of the painting, almost examining it for other unique qualities that might be a little bit strange.
That's right. Good. Well, this is going nicely, and she's got some time left here, then.
And the addition of the purple is a little bit surprising for me. I didn't expect to see that in our foreground, but I'm really enjoying the balance of the purple with some of the more bold yellow components.
Yes, the red. Very good.
You and I are just delighting in her color choices right now. Every time she puts something down, we're like, yes. Yes, yeah. We did want that. We didn't know that we wanted it, but we did. There's so much action going on here from Blake.
Yeah.
And we can see that they are using a fluffy brush to push some of the paint that's in the background right up close to our central figure.
Yes, very careful work that is.
And getting a few spots of blending along the way as well.
Mm-hmm. This is a very interesting painting.
Yeah, I'm looking at the way all of these bits of black and pink and white are swirling around within our central focus figure here. And I feel like it's someone with wings crouching down, maybe. And we now have 5 minutes remaining, just over 5 minutes remaining on our 20-minute timer here. And this is really what I like to call the danger zone of the 20-minute timed painting, because I feel like artists can kind of start making some wild decisions here or trying to play catch up. What do you think, Chris?
Yeah, it's tempting to go for a big... a big splash at this point. Like, you've got your piece mostly done, and it can be tempting to keep working past where it was probably at its best point. So, a tricky time.
Yeah, it's the danger zone of overpainting. But I think all of our artists in this round so far have done a really good job in terms of time management. Checking out Amber, and Amber looks very comfortable in being in this space of adding details now. She seems pretty chill about it.
Mm-hmm. Changed the brush and putting in those fine lines right now.
And we've got kind of a heart symbol going on with this tree, which I think is interesting because... there's almost this sense of desolation with the way that the tree is being executed in this silhouette against all of these cool colors. So it's a cool contrast there.
Yeah. It's it looks really good. The paint has dried just enough to let her put those details in really clean on top.
And we now are getting the continued emphasis of these body lines from Cece. And she's just adding some textural component into the background. I think this is a lavender color going on in the background.
That's a nice choice for sure. That's a nice choice. She did the background second after doing the figure first.
and getting in nice and close here. And the way that CeCe has chosen these colors and where they are on the body, it almost looks like a heat map, which I think is cool.
Oh, that's a nice way of looking at it, for sure. A heat map. Yeah, it does look like that. I can't tell if it's a lavender color or if it's... That's the lighting.
Yeah, whether or not it's white or if it's lavender.
It's hard. I can't tell. I think it is lavender.
Well, either way, we know CeCe is enjoying using it. She is really super stoked. And I love seeing that energy in our final 2 minutes of the round.
Yeah, for sure. Because if you're having fun at this point, it's been a good round for sure. So definitely artists are feeling loose. Once they know they've done the painting that they wanted to, also can be a danger area too. You're feeling too loose and put in an extra detail. That's a challenge of, in the last minute, is whether or not to add that last detail.
Definitely. It can really... The timer can mess with your head in terms of decision-making, because you have to make every single decision on the fly. Back with Katie here, and our, what I believe is our Adam and Eve scene.
Yeah, that's a nice painting, for sure.
There's a joyfulness and playfulness to it that I think is going to resonate.
There really is. It's just such a complete work. It was so carefully done and not overworked. She didn't do much at the end there. It was already complete. This reminds me of like a one picture cartoon, you know?
Yeah, it tells that complete story within one single frame.
It does.
Oh, and I'm starting to notice right now that I think that there are like petals coming out of the hands as well, maybe with a little bit of pink.
Yeah, which way are they going? Are they turning into plants, or are the plants turning into people? I was like, why is this upside down right now?
It's because Katie's just showing off at this point. Just finishing her edges. Back with Natalie here.
This piece is going to look nice in a condo.
Oh, for sure. It really stands up as a piece that can be viewed really nicely up close and getting all of this textural play.
Oh, yeah.
And also from farther away and getting that bold statement of that horizon line.
And just the way this has been painted, on every angle, sort of surprised that it's a seascape at the end for me.
Oh, I'm loving this hit of that orange.
Oh, yeah. So good. Let's put a bid in on that painting. What do you say?
On Natalie's painting?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do it. And as we're talking about that, I think now would be a good time to let everyone know that it is a good opportunity to bid on these pieces, and you can do that at the link that's on your screen as well. You can bid in silent auction.
Yeah, we can ship these paintings to you, and not only are they a great addition to your visual space, but they come with a great story that you saw it completed and really were into what the artist was putting down. So it's a great addition to any collection, or start your collection with a piece from the auction. It's a really good starter price point for sure if you're looking to get into art collecting.
And just knowing that you saw these paintings at every single stage of their completion, and the uniqueness of owning something that you saw it being created, is just, that still blows my mind all the time. I have art battle paintings that I've collected over the years, and every time I look at them, I'm thinking about seeing them being made.
Yeah, I want to buy a painting and have it sent to Sean.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
No, because he lives in the United States, and so it'll be $50 shipping. But if I have it shipped here, it's like $150 shipping.
Well, for our U.S. Viewers out here, we have that nice $50 flat rate shipping, right, Chris?
That's right. We do.
Getting these hits of red in here.
Yeah. This piece, that's a real creation, this piece.
I think that the red at the bottom might be some little mushrooms. Mushrooms seem to be quite the theme this year in Art Battle.
Yeah, the mushroom is becoming popular for sure. This piece is fantastic.
It's so clean.
Let's buy this one too.
Yeah, we're going shopping tonight, guys. So if you want to compete with us in the auction, get in there. we're buying up awesome paintings for the Art Battle Museum.
That's great. So this is a really good round. I don't know how the voting is going to go.
And voting is now open, actually, at the link that's on the screen. And Chris, do you want to describe our tournament structure of what's going to happen for these artists who get the most votes?
Sure. Well, the top two from this round and the top two from the first round will go into a third and final round. We'll have four painters painting again, two from this round, two from the first round. In the third and final round, and the winner of that third round will be the champion. So get your votes in there. Voting is still open for the first round. If you haven't voted yet, you can vote in both the first and the second round right now. Every vote counts, so help us to pick which one of these deserves to be the winner.
I think it's going to be a tough choice as well with these pieces, because there's so many different appeals to all six of them. We have this kind of whimsical playfulness from Katie's piece.
Yeah, there's a good variety. You should buy this whole round and display it in a room together.
Oh my gosh.
Six pieces that were born together, and then hang them all together in your house. I think you should do that.
I love that. That would make such a cool wall above like a long sectional or something like that. Just have all six of those paintings, and then you get to talk about it. That's a cool idea. I really like that.
Yeah, plus this video is on YouTube, so you can watch them being painted again in front of the paintings.
Ah, true. You can relive your glory of your triumphant collecting moment.
Absolutely. You can see them all in their various stages. So they looked, you know, some of them looked complete many times throughout the 20 minutes until the final one, until the final version comes out.
Very cool technique going on from Natalie right now, where she is gliding her fingers along the edges of the painting to complete those edges. That's fun. I don't think I've ever seen that edge painting technique of just like caressing the edges of the painting and all of a sudden they're done.
No, I haven't seen that before either, but she certainly knows how to paint, that's for sure. This piece is wild too.
Yeah, the way that it's come together, I feel like has been such a journey, and watching all of these surprise elements take appearance or make appearances has been really fun. There's elements of surrealism, there's elements of impressionism.
Yeah, there's some really thorough.
Lovely. Okay, artists, bring your stuff back, and it's your turn, audience. Let's get your voting out. Come on, get your cell phones out. These will all be ready to bid on very shortly. But vote now, and vote often. Make it happen, guys. Send an amazing artist to the final round. We'll be announcing the winners of round one and round two in about 15 minutes.
And that was a fantastic second round for Art Battle in San Francisco. Watching the evolution of these pieces was just such a treat.
Absolutely. Artists at work here in the second round. Such a complicated, yet a perfectly balanced compositions. This one, the abstract seascape was especially well painted too. The canyon there with the eye in the sky. A really good round. So pick your favorite and help us pick which two of these artists will go through into the final round.
We will be back in just a few minutes as the votes roll in, and we will be back soon to announce our finalist artists who we're going to get to see paint again in round number three. So stay tuned.
Thank you.
Let's announce round two winners first. You got that?
Yep.
All right, our first round two winner is Nathalie Lenderman. Come on back, Nathalie. Our second round two winner is Elsa. Thank you so much. Elsa, come on back, get your paints. Sorry, Mom, Elsa took that one, but your painting was amazing. All right, our round one winners. First round one winner, Mr. Lopez, El Tadito. Have you seen it at all? Come on up, buddy. Look at the outfit alone. It's just fantastic. You're beautiful. We love you. Work, bitch. And then our finalist, our last finalist, and we're so happy that this happened because he really deserved it. Michael Walker is going to the finals. Mike Dowd going to the finals on his birthday. Big winner, chicken dinner. Guys, keep bidding. We're going to start the finals in about 10 minutes. Those are our winners. Thank you so much, Nathalie, Elsa, Michael, and Mr. Lopez. stage. That's right. Here they come. Give them a round of applause. Yes, indeed. It's time to win that cheddar. Don't forget, if you win tonight, you also get in the pool for the nation final. Actually, what is it? Local finals first, and then the state, and then the nationals. This is the first art battle of the season. Our next art battle will be 420. So you know the theme of that one. It'll be pretty fun. We got the timer ready. Okay, DJ Craig. All right, guys. Let's do this. Artists, are you ready? Raise your hands. Yes, yes. Michael, let's go, birthday boy. Take it home. Okay, guys, we're going to art battle in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Art battle final. Let's get it going. It's home. Let's go clockwise.
All right, we are here for our third and final round for Art Battle in San Francisco tonight. I am so excited to see these finalists go on another canvas with another 20 minutes on the clock.
It's so cool to get to watch them create again, and you get to learn so much more about the artists, not just from their each individual piece that they do, but from the two pieces combined sort of thing, and you get to see more of what they're about. It's really awesome.
Yeah, really getting to get a snapshot into their work within just two pieces is such a unique experience.
Yeah, and we can see here, you know, the start of the time is, you know, critical, but every artist takes it differently. We see one artist with the tons of marker work on canvas already, another artist done the barest of sketches before starting. So really cool to watch them. And we have gallery stretch canvas here in the final round.
Very nice. Very nice. I love checking out Michael right now, and just these very few suggested lines already communicating a face. So minimal and already so impactful.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that he's using maybe your charcoal stick there?
Could be.
Moving over to Natalie here.
All right, Natalie. She really worked it on her first painting and totally took the crowd right along with her, getting here into the final with her sort of, with her abstracted, very medium-heavy landscape.
Yeah, I was really excited to see Natalie paint in her qualifying round, and even more so with the excitement for seeing her painting in the final. When we were checking out her application, she was describing her work as sitting and trying to straddle the line between abstraction and representation within landscapes. And I think that's such a perfect description, and I think she does that so well.
For sure. You know, these artists have worked for many years on their craft of painting, and get to know themselves and go through all stages of identifying what exactly they're working with. It's a great way to art. Do it for the self-development.
100%. It's really, it really puts you to the test as an artist to work within this limited time period, because you don't have any chance, any opportunity to question yourself. You just have to go with your gut and be confident and paint it out.
Yeah, absolutely. And now we're seeing four different approaches to finishing your canvas here, even with Ethel Heights difference, but we have, sorry, what's his artist name?
Eleuteria.
Eleuteria. And they have a very busy canvas again in this round.
And they work so quickly, too. This being a 4-minute piece is just mind-blowing. We have the establishment of perspective going on. We've got some cityscape elements. And I think maybe some portraiture within the sky as well.
Yeah, all of that. That's right. Yeah, all of that. That's right.
All of that in 4 minutes.
Yeah, definitely going to be a contender and a really nice display of breadth of ability between the first painting, which was a portrait, and this one, which is sort of like a perspective landscape. So I think the audience will appreciate that.
Oh, definitely.
I know I do.
I know I do, too. I'm especially enjoying seeing the way that they layer colors, starting with that yellow and then layering the red over top and just getting moments of transparency within that.
Mm-hmm.
Back with Michael here. So happy we're getting to catch this moment of the first color strokes.
Yeah, for sure. Great work by the cameraman. Or maybe Michael waited for the camera to come around to him to do it.
That would be some next level art battle performance.
I think we're starting to see that, to be honest with you. I think we're starting to see. I think your friend in New York was doing that the other night, mm-hmm. flipping his canvas. June?
Yeah, Jaehoon.
Jaehoon, yeah. I think that he was doing it for the camera, and I think that the artists are aware now that we're streaming that it makes this sort of display a little bit different.
Yeah, super. It's such an interesting added element. Art battle goes meta. Getting some nice close-up action of this gorgeous ultramarine blue hitting the canvas.
Yeah, and as we're zoomed in here, we can see all the sketch lines a lot more clearly.
Mm-hmm. And such smooth movements as well.
Yeah. And left-handed, how about that?
How about that?
How about that?
Back over with Natalie, and this piece I can already tell is going to be a stunner. Just check out the way that navy is playing with that cerulean at the bottom of the canvas. Mm-hmm. Do you think that's a waterfall?
I'm not sure, but this is
it. This is cool.
Yeah.
She's literally blowing the paint around right now with her mouth. Amazing.
This is a nice display of tool usage, too. She brings these this eyedropper. This ink, I guess it's ink. It doesn't look that dark.
Yeah, it's so satisfying seeing the way that Natalie is dripping directly from the dropper onto the canvas.
Yeah. I'll tell you this, there's good quality here tonight in San Francisco. And we've been getting a lot of new painters recently, and it's looking good, looking fun every month here.
Back with Ilsa here, and we've got some really gorgeous skin tones going on within this portrait.
Yeah, interesting. Try and figure out what's going on here exactly.
Yeah, I'm wondering whether or not this is a hand across the face, or if this is going to be a completely unexpected element that isn't even a part of the body. I would not be surprised to see that from Ilsa, given all of the elements of the surprise that she gave us in her qualifying round piece.
Yeah. And again, showing a totally different composition here in her second piece from her first piece.
Yeah, giving us that variety of showing us that surreal landscape with the super dark, moody colors in the qualifying, and then going for a portrait in our final. We are officially halfway through our final round for Art Battle San Francisco tonight.
Halfway, right? This painting doesn't, I mean, it looks pretty good, but it doesn't look like it's halfway done yet. He's going to have to sprint.
I feel like we're going to see some really big, bold strokes moving forward in our last 10 minutes from Ilsa. Mm-hmm. I think that she is nearing completing the details that she wants to get established on the face. But yeah, that with the amount of negative space that's still going on and with the level of concept we're now expecting from Ilsa, we definitely want to start seeing her going into other elements of the piece.
Oh, yeah. We're going to come back around here and she's going to have put the whole thing in like this in some bright colored hair or something.
Oh, I'd love that. And speaking of brightly colored, back with Eleuterio, and they are continuing to add all of these details. It's something that's really interesting about them that I've been enjoying is at every stage, their piece feels very detailed. And then every time we come back, there's more details somehow layered on there, but it doesn't feel too busy either.
Yeah, it's really hard to do that. It can get too busy really fast, but somehow they're managing to. The more they put in, it's not complicating the piece at all.
Is this a truck? The back of a truck that we're seeing in the middle of the road, in the middle of the composition?
Yeah, it could be like an RV or something like that.
And then we have this blue happening in front of the truck. I'm wondering whether or not that's going to turn out to be a figure. A little figure hanging out in there. Looks like we'll get to start seeing right now.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's somebody on a scooter, I think. And now getting into some text elements as well. Oh, it says no parking.
Right.
This pink is so perfect. It's like right on the line of between hot pink and like a purple pink. This is actually my favorite pink.
Yeah, it's a good pink. Did he use all markers in his first painting?
I think so. But they're definitely paint markers. We can see the paint sloshing around in the marker as he's applying it on the canvas.
Oh, yeah. What a great tool.
So satisfying also to see that. Moving back over to Natalie, and we can see that she's putting her face up so close to the canvas and using more of that blowing technique, which is really interesting when you think about that she's literally blowing onto clouds to cause their directionality. So she is the wind in this painting.
That's so cool. Yeah, very interesting to see her. The second painting here, you see we've learned a lot about her more because we've seen two of her paintings now. But you've checked out these artists' studio work. Is this what her work looks like usually?
Very indicative. Very indicative of Natalie's studio work. She really found a way to translate what she's doing in the studio into what she's bringing to the live easel right now. This feels very true to her style and her brand.
Right. Very cool. Nice to see her here at Art Battle.
Amazing. So much happening. I hear from Elsa, and we're getting all of these strong strokes that we were looking for.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I knew when we came back around that we'd be at this stage for sure.
Yeah, getting this, getting to the point of this kind of bold transformation. And the hit of black is so welcome as well, because it's really getting into that contrast. And I like that the hair is actually dark as well, but it's looking light being contrasted by that black.
Yeah. Good choices for sure. We still don't know what exactly is covering the mouth of this figure. It's going to be a scarf. Is it a hand? Like you said, it's not a hand because she would have been working on it already, I think, if it was going to be a hand. There's only like 4 minutes left.
Yeah, we are nearing our finish line here.
Oh, who's it going to be?
Who is it going to be? These guys are absolutely painting their hearts out. And only one person who is up at the easels right now will emerge as our winner of the night. And if you are viewing on the stream right now, it is your job to help us make that decision. So as the minutes count down, if you're not already, make sure that you are registered to vote at artbattle.com/AB2460.
That's right. Get in there and help us decide which one of these painters deserves to be Art Battle champion here tonight in San Francisco.
The colors are really just dancing off of this piece.
And so interesting that that yellow in this piece, which is so predominant, was done like in the first 30 seconds or so.
Yeah, just such fantastic work, and such a thoughtfully layered piece.
Yeah. A lot of pen and marker work here tonight.
Yeah, these artists definitely wanted to have some fun with that marker. Ooh, checking out the, oh, getting our countdown now.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That's Art Battle final right there in the books. Woo! Well done. Okay, now it's your turn. Everybody, please vote for your favorite right now. All the art will be available to bid on very shortly. Make sure you bid on the other art as well. We'll have the results in about 10 or 15 minutes. Round of applause for the artists again. Thank you so much, guys. You killed it.
Wow, what a final for Art Battle San Francisco. These guys really brought it.
four very different paintings, all some of them similar to the first paintings by these artists, some of them completely different. And now it is time to help us choose which one of these artists here tonight is the champion. You can also bid to take these paintings home, or in this case, have them shipped to you. We will ship in United States for $50. So you can have them shipped to you. This is a piece here we're looking at by Natalie. This is her second abstract landscape of the competition. A very cool piece.
And the play of the metallics, just used super subtly, is something that I really enjoy about this piece as well. Oftentimes it can be really easy to overemphasize metallics, but it's just some thoughtful little hits there. So just a reminder to everyone to make sure that you vote at the link that is on your screen. Only one artist will emerge the winner, and that artist is moving forward to the San Francisco City Final. Isn't that right, Chris?
That's right. They will be the first artist qualified for the next round of playdowns. So this artist will automatically move forward. That does not mean that we won't see them again sometime this season. Why go all that time without seeing our favorite painters? So we often do see, especially in cities that have art battles every month, we see winning painters come back and compete again. So, but I don't know who's going to take it here tonight. These paintings are all very different, and we're going to find out soon, though. But get your votes in there. We're going to be back in a few minutes with the winner announcement.
Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
He's right there. Yulitiero. Congratulations. Winner, winner, right there. Congratulations. Mike, we love you. Happy birthday. Join me for a shot over there. Happy New Year, Rob. I love you very much. Congratulations. Get him on the stage for me, please. Get him on the stage, please. Congratulations. Give him a round of applause. Beautiful work. You are going on to the city finals. Congratulations. Thank you so much. Next art battle, 420, guys. Make sure you get it. Stick around, dance, let's have some fun. We're going to be closing the bidding very soon.
A huge congratulations to our winning artist of tonight's art battle in San Francisco. Eleuterio Lopez.
All right, way to go.
They did just such a fantastic job with layering all of these different colors and giving us such an amazing opportunity to discover all of these details within their pieces.
Yeah, and really got a lot of the crowd on their side during their first piece. Which garnered a lot of votes, a lot of bids in the auction, and got a lot of people watching this artist very closely.
Wow, what a night. What a night. Huge congratulations to all 12 of our artists who stepped up to the easel tonight. And it takes so much courage and creativity to paint and compete live and reveal your artistic skills at the easel in front of everyone. So we really appreciate it. And if you're an artist watching at home and you are wanting to paint, we take artist applications. So head to artbattle.com/artists and we would love to see your work. Also a huge shout out to our San Francisco team who is at the venue right now and has just done such an amazing job throwing this wonderful event.
Yes, thanks guys. And really appreciate you putting together such a great event. Thanks to the artists, all the artists, and we're meeting so many more in San Francisco. Thanks to you, Morgan, for leading us through this event so capably.
Aw, shucks. Thank you, Chris. Thank you for joining me and giving your amazing art battle insights. Once again, everyone, my name is Morgan Booth, and we have been co-hosting with Art Battle co-founder Chris Pemberton. We are going to be on the stream later this week on Saturday. We're going to be in Belgrade, Serbia, and then later that day, that night, in Mexico City. So we have more exciting live competitive painting coming at you. Stay tuned to all of the Art Battle socials to see what's coming up next.
Sounds so fun. All right. Thanks, everyone. Good night.